Greetings, brothers and sisters. This is Brother Art. I'd like to encourage you today to keep focus on life and what we are to offer. We have to have a purpose. I'd like to share a scripture. One of the scriptures my father left for me and was serious about. I didn't understand it as I was young before he passed. It wasn't until I was going through some of his Bible and looking at some of the notes that he left. And he had several that he left for me, but one of them was based around a scripture from the book of Proverbs, chapter 7, verses 1 through 3. I'm reading from the New Living Translation. It says, "Follow my advice, my son. Always treasure my commands. Obey them and live. Guard my teachings as your most precious possession. Tie them on your fingers as a reminder. Write them deep within your heart." Obeying the commands wasn't just obeying the commands of my father. Like myself and many of us that are willing to witness that we're human beings, my father was fallible, was not perfect, nor am I, nor are you. And one of the things that he said with confidence was, if we kept the word of God in our hearts and in our minds, to meditate on it day and night, when we find ourselves in struggle and any kind of persecution in our personal lives, you know, whether it's school, business, you know, work related, family related, spouse related, children related, we will find that the word of God will bring a different kind of peace to us. So I want to encourage you today. One of the things that I find myself thinking about more and more as I get older is the fact that one day I will be gone. And my ultimate goal is to make it to heaven. And when I reach heaven, I want to be able to face the Lord and say that I fulfilled what he placed in my heart, my purpose. And there's a reason why we have these feelings sometimes. Sometimes it's not good feelings, but you know the difference. But I want to be able to stand in front of God and not worry about if I fulfilled my purpose. I have an opportunity and good health right now to be able to stand and encourage people. And I have a certain platform that God has placed me in. And I'm grateful because he didn't have to do it. So I want to read the last scripture before I end this particular message. How will you answer the king when he says, "What did you do with what I gave you?" The scripture is going to be coming from Matthew 25, verse 23. His Lord said to him, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of the Lord." The Lord had a blessing to the reading of his word today. And I want you to know, you may not be famous. You may not be the person that everyone knows right now, but God knows you, okay? And he has placed strategically certain people in your life. So when you say that God doesn't speak to you, he does. He's speaking to you right now. He uses vessels. He uses sometimes things that we run across, sometimes the sky, sometimes the weather, something that will move you. I want you to think about that the next time when something hit your spirit. And he wants you to be faithful with the little that you have. And if you are faithful with the little that you have, you'll see an increase in favor of God. Father God, I want you to right now touch those that will take the opportunity to have an ear and listen. I ask that you use them for your glory. For those that are seeking salvation, Lord, I ask that you forgive us of our sins, knowingly and unknowingly, and give us another opportunity, Lord, as we are blessed with the day to live in your presence and serve for those that come in our path that they're touched. In Jesus' mighty name, God bless you. Peace and blessings always.